With me now in the studio is Leo Koot, the new executive chairman of LGO Energy, soon to be renamed Columbus Energy Resources. Leo, morning to you. Good to see you.
Good morning, Andrew.
And congratulations on the new role.
Well, thank you very much. Exciting times.
Exciting times indeed. Was it a hard decision for you to make?
It took some thinking. And as I said yesterday in the strategic meeting with our investors, it took me about a month to really do my due diligence and to get down into the guts of the resources and the exploration potential. But having done that work, I'm convinced that it is a good opportunity and we're going to make something great out of this.
And where do you see those opportunities?
It's three main elements, I believe, in Trinidad and beyond. The Gudrun, which is going to be our moneymaker, and that's going to create a free cash flow so that we can venture into large, exciting exploration. And we already have one of those exploration prospects in our portfolio, which is in the Southwest Peninsula of Trinidad, which has got significant potential beyond 200 million barrels of oil in place potentially. So real material exploration within the existing portfolio. But that's not where we're going to stop, because as of yesterday, we branded ourselves as an oil production-led exploration company focused on South America. Mm-hmm. So we will venture into South America because I believe that's an underexplored area, specifically land.
And as you say, changes are already being made. You've got a team, you're sending a team to Trinidad next week?
Yeah, on the 16th, Stuart Ahmed, who is an extremely very well experienced reservoir optimization specialist. He's got a great track record. He just came from Madagascar Oil, where he implemented a steam flood, similar size, similar type of operations. So I've got great faith in him to make sure that he's going to do a great job.
So we've talked about Stuart. Let's talk about yourself. Run us through your own background.
I started my career in Shell. So first 13 years of my career, I got a real solid engineering training. Then moved on into the service sector. So I worked with Halliburton and Well Dynamics for a while, which is a very valuable experience to see how it is on the other side of the fence. We managed to build out Halliburton to a material, or Well Dynamics into a material service company, with opportunities in the North Sea. And when I then looked at those opportunities, I thought, well, I want to get involved in that. So together with the CEO of Well Dynamics, we raised an energy fund. We called it the EDP. We raised $350 million. We started investing that fund in the North Sea. When we wrapped up the fund, we sold, or some of the assets went to Taka Abu Dhabi National Energy Company. And then Taka asked me to set up the UK business initially, which I've grown from 6 people to 2,000 people. From 20,000 barrels initially to 60,000 barrels by the time I've left in 5 years' time.
So you got the track record there. Now you're at LGO Columbus.
Got to do the same.
You come up with a 3-year plan?
Yes. So first, talk about the first year. It's all about creating that free cash flow. We need to get Gudrun and the producing assets to a point where wash their face and provide that extra capital to really work up the exploration portfolio to make sure that we are ready for the transformational growth. So first year, focused on getting our act together. And then year 2 and 3, that's when you see the exponential growth. So get in now.
When you say getting your act together, is that going to include the raising of more funds?
The getting act together means a couple of things. The LGO has gone through quite a difficult period, like many oil companies, since 2014. LGO, one of the few companies who came out of that recession reasonably intact, with the assets still owned by LGO. So that's a very good starting point. But as a result of the history, the whole team and the whole operations were set in a legacy mindset. So they were worried about what happened last year, mm-hmm. and found it difficult to look to the future. So with me we're going to be looking at the future rather than see what happened in the past. As a result of that legacy, the company was focused on just drilling wells to get the extra production. Whereas Stuart and I believe there is a raft of other opportunities, lower cost, to get to the equivalent production add. So that's what I mean with getting our act together. It's refocusing the business and making sure that we get a maximum bang for our buck.
So refocusing the business, the closing of one chapter, the opening of another.
Correct.
An exciting time for investors.
Absolutely. So come in now and buckle up for the ride.
Leo, really good to meet you. Thanks very much indeed.
Thank you.